champion Donovan Bailey to contend with, but he is, of course, the reigning champion. The 100 meters Olympic final. Well, no wonder. Not sure Christie wasn't responsible. It's very rare he gets a false start. Very rare indeed. I think he's accepted that. We'll see where the marksman goes. This time they go. Bolden got a good one. Christie not so good away. And his recall. Donovan Bailey. Well, that was a late recall. Azima. Bolden got a very good start. Was it too good? We'll see where the marksman goes this time. Fredericks usually just beat the gun. Suppose you could say it was nearly a brilliant start. The Olympic 100 meter final. And the third time they go, and Christie got quite a good one. Oh! Well, is it Christie or Bolden? Who is it? Linford seemed to me to get a good start. Again, the question is, was it too good? If it's Christie or Bolden, they go out. And I've got a feeling that they're looking at Christie. The defending champion looks like being thrown out for two false starts. Yes. Well, he's come here to defend his title with dignity. He's been thrown out of the final for two false starts. It looked like a good start to me. And what a finish to Christie's major international career. He's battled his way into this final. And this is worse than being beaten in the actual race, not being able to defend the title at all. Actually, Christie has now taken the marker off, I think. He's not happy. If he gets reinstated in the Olympic final, it could be a surprise. To say the least. The markers have been taken off Christie's block. The 100 metres in the Olympic final is always dramatic. But this a real test of nerve. Now Christie, I think, is refusing to accept this. Christie has been asked to leave the arena, and the champion walks away without being able to defend the title. Two false starts. He not only can't believe it, he simply doesn't believe it. So now the man who's put together such a great international record is forced to be a spectator. Well, this has been a real test for everyone. The lineup is Marsh, the Olympic 200 meter champion in Le Mans. Christie now gone in two. Bolden, the former world champion, junior champion, Trinidad in three. Mitchell in four. Fredericks in five. Bailey in six. Azinwa seven. Green eight. Once again, they settle for the Olympic final. This time they get away. Bolden got away well. Also going well alongside him is Dennis Mitchell. And it's Bolden! And Bolden can... Bailey! Bailey wins it. Bolden second. Fredericks third. Bailey won it, 9-8. a new world record. Tremendous run by the man from Canada, who's put now, alongside his world title, the Olympic title. He's taken it from Linford Christie, who comes out now to tremendous applause from the crowd. Atto Bolden looked like being second there, and Frankie Fredericks third. Christie now saying farewell to the crowd. He's defended this Olympic title with dignity. And he didn't get the chance to actually compete. That's his great friend who he's trained with, Frankie Fredericks. I don't think Linford, possibly watching from the starter's end of the track, probably knows what happened. What a sad finale. But what a moment for Donovan Bailey, world champion and now Olympic champion. Gail Devers sympathizes, and Christie walks away.